everybody. It is Trina here, Ms. Beautifile, and we're live from the Monell Chemical Sense Center in Philly. I'm here with Dr. Pamela Dalton. You may have recognized her from a video beforehand, and she is giving me a test today. What? We're going to test my sense of smell. If there's anyone out there right now, hello. Welcome, welcome. So tell me, what am I going to be doing with this test?
Okay. So what you're going to be doing is what we think the olfactory system is important for, which is to be able to figure out what you're smelling when you walk through the world.
Oh, my God. I'm going to be terrible at this, you guys. I'm going to be terrible. I don't think my sense of smell is really acute, so let's hope for the best.
Well, we'll see.
Okay.
All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these special pens that have odors inside them.
Okay.
And I'm going to sort of wave it under your nose, and you can see if you can smell it now.
Sorry, that was a little bit of an embarrassing reaction. Hi, Monick. Nice to see you here. We are doing a sniff test right now, and I don't know if you saw my reaction to this one, but this is very, spirited. I would say it's menthol, maybe, like spearmint? No. Okay. Give me some options to choose from here.
Okay. Would you say it was closer to orange, blackberry, strawberry, or pineapple?
Oh, that's wild. None of those. Can I smell it one more time? None of those smell like that to me. I would say pineapple?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Oh my goodness, this is going to be so hard. I'm sweating it out. Just for you guys who have joined, I am getting a scent test to see if I can identify certain scents. And for the first one, I didn't do so well. I smelled mint when it was actually pineapple. Why is that the case? What happened there?
I'm not sure, but you know, it's very hard for us when you don't have choices. When
okay.
you have to think about what whether this could be one of a thousand things you've smelled
right.
to actually link it to that identity.
Okay.
Generally, when we smell things, we remember where we smelled them or
right.
who were that perfume or you know where we were when we smelled coconut, for example,
right.
on the beach when we were putting sunscreen on.
Yeah,
right?
And this yeah. makes sense because I don't know if you guys saw my other video that I did with the perfumer at In Cosmetics. She created a space fragrance, and when I smelt that fragrance, it smelled like space, which was amazing, but I couldn't identify the key components
right.
that made that space smell.
Right.
So
right.
this is the challenge that I'm still having.
That's very common, very common.
Okay.
And even with complex mixtures, it's very hard for us to figure out what is actually in there unless you're a trained perfumer or a
right.
chef. Like you go out to eat at a restaurant and you taste this divine sauce
right.
and you sit there thinking, well, I know I'm not going to get the recipe from the chef, but can I make this at home? What is in here?
Right.
That's really hard for us to do as humans.
Okay.
But we're very good at smelling. So.
Got it.
Okay.
So let's try
another one.
Number two. All
without,
right.
Without you knowing anything about what it might be. And then I will give you the four choices, and you can see if you do better than that.
Okay, this is a very light scent. They all smell like mint to me. I don't know.
All right, we'll take
you know,
a look at this.
In my defense, I just got a cold on Thursday,
okay.
so maybe that's why everything smells dull. Oh, okay. So what she's done is she's given me some examples here. I'm going to hold them up. So these are the things that I could be experiencing, and I have to guess. So we have smoke, which it wasn't. We have leather, which it's not. We have glue. We have glue, and we have grass. Oh, gosh. I would say grass.
It really is leather.
It's leather. Oh, my gosh. I am the worst. This is terrible.
But try it again now knowing okay. that. And I think okay. it'll come into better range.
Oh, you know what? It's very faint. And now I can smell it.
Yes.
All right.
It's
guys.
Like a pattern match, right? You're smelling something that's activating your olfactory system. But you've got to get a pattern for something that you don't smell all the time
right.
to match it to something that you have smelled before
okay.
to be able to do that.
Hey, Hygienic Elements LCC, mm-hmm. how are you doing? If you guys have any questions for Dr. Dalton, definitely let me know. I am bombing the smell test right now. I'm going to blame it on the cold. But, you know, maybe it's just that my sniffer isn't trained. Now, you were saying people can actually actually train and make their sense of smell more acute. Is that correct?
Absolutely.
Okay.
If you tried this every day, I guarantee you, you would start nailing it.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to take this home with me, your sniff samples,
yes,
and I'm going to try to start nailing.
Yes,
I'm going to be trained by the next time. I'm going to be prepared for this.
This one might be a little easier. You might even be able to get it without looking at the options.
Okay. This is bananas.
Yeah.
I totally smelled this one. Okay, I got one. Bananas. This is the banana, banana
right.
smell. And so here were some of my options here. Very easy. Thank you, Hygienic Elements LLC. I know, I finally got one right. Right. Thank you for celebrating with me. Okay, do you want to try maybe like two more? Does
yeah,
that feel good?
Yeah, two more. That sounds good.
Okay. Oh, you missed what's going on really fast. Okay, so what Dr. Dalton is doing is she is testing my sense of smell, which apparently isn't very good. And there's two things that they're looking at here. One is, can I actually smell something? Or, you know, do I even identify that there's an odor? Right? Because there's people that can't smell
That's
or have
right.
trouble smelling.
Yes.
What is that called?
Well, it's called anosmia if you have no ability to smell.
Okay. Anosmia? Is that
anosmia. Anosmia.
Okay.
And if you are impaired, and then we call that hyposmia. So it's reduced sensitivity to smell.
I see.
Yes.
And what influences that? Is it like sickness or?
A lot of things.
Okay.
Number one, as we grow older, our sense of smell declines, just like our vision and our hearing.
Everything declines
right?
as we get older.
Yes.
Wow.
And colds, things that block.
Could this be one reason, sorry to interrupt, could this be one reason why, I don't know, this is probably as a horrible stereotype, but they say like sometimes like older women and perfumes and the perfume is really strong. It's because for them it smells okay, but maybe for people whose sense of smell is more acute, it's too strong.
Absolutely.
Whoa, okay. There.
Number one, is something they probably wear the same or very similar scents all
yes,
the time.
Yes, I see too. That's
so they get adapted to it, but also their ability to smell is less acute than someone who might be 20 or 30 years old.
Right.
So, you know, I was essentially a prisoner of my mother's perfume addiction.
A prisoner?
Because she would use the same scent and she would spray it so much because she wanted to experience it. And she couldn't smell it well anymore. And then I would get in a car with her, and I would be absolutely asphyxiated.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes,
and so she had adapted to it. No big deal for her, but
no
you
big
hadn't.
Deal. And I hadn't, yes.
Okay,
yes,
I'm ready to try another
all right,
one.
This one you might actually get without the clues.
Okay, before I smell it, we're going to read Hygienic Elements, LCC's question. I recall nasal spray with zinc have the same negative effect.
I guess what she's talking about is it has a disruptive ability on your sense of smell.
Right.
Interestingly, nobody has ever been able to actually demonstrate that in a study, but
okay.
it's very common for people to experience that after using the zinc nasal spray.
Interesting. Okay.
But we've never been able to actually pin it down in a study. But
right.
not that many studies have been done either.
And that's an interesting thing about science is there's, you know, some stuff out there that we just haven't been able to pin down yet. We're still learning about our sense of smell and what some of the issues are, and you know, a lot of science is coming to light. Is that
absolutely,
correct?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Right. Oh, super science style science news. Thank you for joining us. It's good to see you here. I am doing a sniff test, and apparently my sniffer is not too good. Hopefully I'm going to have to develop some other senses.
You rocked the last one. So.
Okay. I can kind of smell this one already, and I worry what I'm going to say because I said it like a million times. All right, let me smell. Is it peppermint?
Yeah.
Oh my God, finally. Finally, I got one right. So the options were, let me show the options. So this is how I guess they normally test. We said that one thing was, can you smell? The other thing was, can you identify what that smell is?
Yes.
So how would you rate me so far when it comes to
you definitely can't smell, but this is a really difficult task. And generally when we do this, we don't do what I was doing to you, which is just give you the pen to
you
smell.
Mean, you mean humiliate me
yes,
in front of
exactly.
people.
But we give them these options, and that
okay.
makes it much easier because now you only have to compare what you're smelling
right.
with four things instead
right.
of 1,000 things that it could possibly
right.
be.
Right, so let me update the latecomers here. So what happened was I just smelled this. I identified it correctly as peppermint, but there was a bunch of options that I could choose from. And without this, I would have been totally lost, though, because it's very difficult to identify a smell if you don't have the options unless you are trained to do so, yes. right? And yes. so your nose, you have to develop your nose.
You have to develop that connection between the pattern of what you're smelling and the identity match in your brain.
Right, right. And I'd be interested in hearing how many of you guys think you would rock this test. I'm certainly not rocking it, but tell me, do you guys think that you have an acute sense of smell? Do your friends tell you that you can smell these interesting things? Have you encountered any weird situations that you want to ask Dr. Dalton since we're here? We're going to do one more, so prepare your questions if you have one, because we're going to have to shoot out of here in the next, like, 2 minutes. Uh-oh. She's going to pull a hard one. I see her focusing. Very nervous.
See, I still have to check myself to be sure.
This is really fascinating, though. Yes. I had no idea that there was so much involved in scent. I've been learning a lot about it lately. All right. You know, and I learned... I think I just got a hint of what that one was. I learned that a professional perfumer, when they get to the mastery level, mm-hmm. is called a nose,
yeah.
which is a compliment.
Yes.
Do you have a name for somebody who achieves, what is it? They've mastered smell?
Oh, no, we
in the
actually
lab
don't.
Here?
I mean, we call people super smellers, but, you know, that could also refer to the odors that they give off themselves.
Right.
So, you know,
so I'm going to smell this, and we're going to take our last question here. Mm-hmm. It's from Supernova Style Science News. She says, I think I could do good. I can smell things usually very well and identify them. Oh my goodness. Well, we'll have to sit down at some point and we'll have to do a test now that I know how it's yes. done. Yes. So you can test this at home with your friends too. All right, well, let me give this one a shot. Okay. Motor oil? I don't know. It hits you, like it goes through your nose and it shoots into your brain. And if anyone's ever had a headache while smelling perfume, I imagine that this is what that feels like.
All right.
Very sharp.
Let me help you out.
Oh,
here.
I think I know what it is already though, now that I've got my options. So these were my options. You guys saw my reaction. These are the very unsavory options. Onion, garlic, sauerkraut, and carrot. Okay. I think it's garlic. It is totally garlic. And now that we've identified it, I've smelled this, like, going through Gilroy in California, right?
Yes.
The garlic capital
right,
of the world. Right, right. It smells like this, but when you have it in concentrated form, mm-hmm. it is like a punch in the face. Oh, my goodness.
But
wow.
it's also the kind of odor that's very context dependent.
Okay.
Because at dinner time, when you walk into your kitchen, this
yes.
is a good odor, right?
That's crazy. That's true.
Right.
Garlic can be a good smell, but here it was
But if
totally...
you open your bedroom window in the morning and it wafts into your bedroom at
right.
7 a.m.,
yes.
that's totally not something
it's just
you want to
totally
smell.
Totally wrong. So, right,
yeah.
right. Yeah, you don't want to kiss anybody with, like, garlic
exactly.
mouth, right? Ugh.
Yeah,
so it's
right,
the same
right.
thing. Okay,
yeah.
so perception plays a role, right? Or any experiences that you've had with it before, but also, what was this, perception, and then also concentration.
Yes, concentration,
okay, concentration.
The intensity, and the context.
Yes.
Things that are good in one context can be bad in another. So.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh,
like
my God.
Garlic.
This was fantastic. I want to thank everyone who's joined us today. Unfortunately, we got a cutout right now. Oh, the brother breathing, you're just joining in. We're just leaving. We just did a sniff test. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to save this video so you can watch it later. Lots of interesting stuff about fragrances and scent, and you're just going to feel like you know a ton after this. It was very educational for me. Thank you so much
Thank
for
you.
Doing this. I had so much fun.
Thank
All
you.
Right, we'll see you guys
Bye.
Later. Bye.